Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what to do if you have a problem right when you need ProPresenter on a weekend, for example. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter, and my name is Paul Alan Clifford. Before we get started, if you'd like to get more content like this delivered every week, go ahead, subscribe, click the bell icon, etc. So, I sometimes get this question, you know, it's a Sunday morning, and Renewed Vision, people assume, is closed. So what do you do if you have a problem? Well, that's actually not exactly the best assumption. As it turns out, there are people that monitor the support all throughout the weekend. So, what should you do if you have a problem? Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So, head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Well, there are a couple of things that I would do. First off, fire off an email to support@renewedvision.com. If it's something that's urgent, like it's a showstopper, ProPresenter's not firing up, etc., if it's something that has to be taken care of today, add urgent to the subject line. And then they should be able to see that, prioritize you, and get help. If it's not something that has to be dealt with that day, leave that word out. I don't want you trying to jump in front of other people in line using urgent when it's not urgent. So do keep that in mind. Secondly, once you've done that, feel free to hop onto the official ProPresenter users community that I run along with Renewed Vision. Ask your question. Tell us that you've already fired off an email to support. Depending on who's looking at it, they may have a solution to you that even gets there before support does. But that doesn't mean that they will or they won't. We, quite frankly, don't know, because it could be that support is writing your email while you're writing the question, and by the time I or one of the other moderators approves your question, you've already gotten your answer back. But it's also the case that it could be that I'm looking at it, it pops up, I hit reply, approve it, hit reply, start typing, and I can get your answer faster. Now, with that said, I admit that I don't know everything. I have worked in technical support before, not for Renewed Vision, but for another company. And part of the strength of tech support is that they hear a wide variety of problems, and they tend to start collecting solutions, even if they're kind of oddball solutions. So, perfect example. the company that I worked with had a touch screen, and there was a setting in Windows. If you had that setting selected and you programmed it with that setting turned on, it would make the touch screen look odd. Let's just say odd. More than once, I would get that call and someone would say, yeah, I think I broke it. I think there's something wrong with the hardware, blah, blah, blah. But as soon as they started describing the problem, I knew the solution. And it was a simple solution. And so I would tell them what setting to change, tell them to try it again. And more than once, the people would say, no, that can't be it. I'd say, just humor me. I bet it is. And it was, because it was an odd thing, but I had heard it probably 100 times, not exaggerating. So it could be the support knows of a problem that I haven't heard of, that isn't common enough that it's been in the community, and they know of a solution because they've heard it 100 times, quite literally. So it's worth firing off an email to them. So those are the things that I would do if I had a problem with ProPresenter on, say, for example, Sunday morning. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro, the number 7 and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Alan Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.